Good afternoon, students. Today we are going to discuss digital signal processing lab. Subject code is 17EEL68 and by Professor Vanilla DA and Professor Amya K. Now, to first experiment is verification of sampling theorem. The aim of this experiment is to verify sampling theorem for critical frequency, undersampling, and oversampling using the simulation software MATLAB. Dear students, now we will see the simulation of your sampling theorem in MATLAB. Okay, this is a program of your sampling theorem. So, program for verification of sampling theorem. Now, the first command is CLC. CLC means, what is the meaning for CLC means, whatever the data which is stored previously, that will clears in the command window. Okay, if you give CLC, whatever the data which is stored in the command window, that will be cleared. The next one is clear all. So, whatever the values you have declared earlier, that all values will be cleared. And the next, close all. Close all means whatever the windows which is open for the previous program, that will be closed. Generally, for every program, we should give all these three commands. Okay. Now, F1 is the nothing but your input frequency. The input frequency we are going to give 50 hertz. The next one, we are going to set the time period. I'm going to set the time period 0 to 0.1 and so the time will be taken from 0 to 0.1 is 0 to 0.001, next to 0.002, like that it will take up to 0.1. Now I'm going to take your sine waveform, y equal to sine 2 pi f1 into t. Fm is nothing but your maximum frequency, which is I'm going to take as a F1 frequency, that is 50 hertz. Now I'm going to explain about the undersampling. Okay, undersampling means your sampling frequency, I'm going to take 1.5 into Fm. Fm is the maximum frequency of your input. Okay, Fm is nothing but your maximum frequency of your input signal, of that is nothing but your sine waveform frequency. Now that will be taken, which will be multiplied with 1.5 to show the undersampling. Now sampling time is Ts equal to 1 by Fs. Now I am going to choose the sampling time period, that is Tx equal to 0 is to Ts into 0.1. Ts is nothing but your 1 by Fs value. Okay. M is nothing but your maximum size of your sampling time axis. Okay. Next I am going to choose Ys equal to cosine waveform. Cosine waveform, it is will be figure 1 is nothing but the cosine waveform will be displayed. Now I am going to take the subplot. Subplot is nothing but the entire screen will be splitted into how many screen you want, sub screens that I can make. So I am going to make three for the first three is nothing but splitted into three rows, and the first one is in which column, which one I have to place. 3, 1, 1 means, so it will be splitted into three rows. In that first corner, first plot will be plotted. Next plot means nothing but it will plot the waveform t comma y, that is time axis versus amplitude axis. Next your grid on means your outer line will be showing. Next title, whatever the title you want to give, that you can give it in the title, that is title which in the, which will be inside the quote. Next x label, if you want to label x axis, that is time axis, and y axis, that is amplitude axis, that you can name it as time in seconds and amplitude in volts. Now again I'm coming to the next point, subplot. So again your subplot will be three rows will be splitted. In that first row only, second it will be plotted. First already we have signed, we have plotted the cosine waveform. Now again the after the this one process, it will be plotted in the second place. In the first row, it will be plotted in the second place. Next you are going to take the stem. Stem means Tx comma Yx. Stem means plot means that at point zero, that is time t is equal to 0, it will plot what is the amplitude. But stem means here it will show the complete line, that is from 0 to amplitude it will show. Next for that the grid will be on. Again title we are going to give, that is discrete signal sampled at Ts is equal to fm hertz. Next to x label, y label, that your wish. Next you are going to take the subplot. Subplot is 3, 1, 3. It will be splitted into three rows. Again, the screen will be splitted into three. In the first row, it will be plotted in the third place. Again, we have to make the plot Tx, Ys. Again, the grid will be on. So, the required sinusoidal signal will be obtained. Now, X label, Y label you have to give. So, this is about your undersampling. Now, we will go to the right sampling. Right sampling in the sense, FS is nothing but your sampling period. It should be, FS should be equal to twice than that of your maximum frequency. This is your sampling theorem statement. Right sampling means your frequency, that is sampling frequency, should be equal to twice than that of your maximum frequency. Maximum frequency is nothing but your input frequency. Now your sampling time will be 1 divided by fs. So for that you are going to choose the time axis. Your ts is nothing but your sampling period. The 0 to 0.1 it will be plotted. So you are going to take m is equal to maximum size of tx. Now, Ys you are going to consider as a cosine waveform, and that figure will be taken as second figure. Okay, already we have given for figure 1, so I have to name it as a 2. So for the second figure, now subplot will be same again. It will be splitted into 3 screen. Then the entire screen will be splitted into 3 rows. Then first plot will be plotted, and then the second plot will be T, Y. So the T, Y will be plotted. So T is nothing but your this time axis will be 0 to 0.1, and Y is nothing but your sine. That will be plotted here, right sampling, and the grid will be on, is nothing but the outer border will be shown. The title you are going to give, again your sinusoidal waveform will be Y of T, and X label will be time in seconds, and Y label will be amplitude in volts. Now subplot will be, the entire screen will be divided into 3. In that it will be in the waveform will be plotted in the second position. Now again you have to plot the stem Tx, Ys, and then grid will be on, so the outer line will be on. Now title will be given as such, and X label, Y label will be given, and the output, that subplot will be the final output. It will be plotted in the third place. Now plot Tx, Yx. Now again the grid will be on. So similar, like we have to give the title and x axis, y axis. Now next one is oversampling. It is nothing but oversampling means your fs should be greater than or equal to fm. So here I am going to choose fs will be 10 times your fm. Okay, so that is nothing but your oversampling. So same thing again, I am going to choose the sampling period, time period. Tx will be 0 to Ts into 0.1. The maximum size of your Tx will be passed on to this m, and then again Ys will be cosine waveform. So next I am going to name it as a figure 3. The subplot will be, the entire screen will be splitted into three rows. Then in the first place, in the first row, the first plot will be plotted, and again plot T, Y. Again the T, Y means T is nothing but your this one, time which we have taken 0 to 0.1, and Y is nothing but your sine waveform. Then again this one plot will be, grid will be on. So title you have to give, X label, Y label. Again next subplot will be taken in the third, three screen will be splitted. In the first place, second it will be plotted, stem again. So grid will be on. So you have to give the title. So X label is T, time in seconds, and Y label amplitude in volts. Again subplot you have to take. Again plot Tx, Ys, grid will be on, title will be given. Now I will simulate the output. So this is about your program of your sampling theorem. Now I will run the program. So if I run the program, see your this one is nothing but your sinusoidal waveform input I have given. And the next one, this is nothing but your discrete signal sampled at fs is equal to 3 times your fm. Okay, so this is nothing but your oversample. If I recover this signal, so I will get, that is nothing but your original signal. Okay, original signal I have recovered. This is nothing but your signal is sampled. The signal is sampled, that is nothing but, this is the sampled signal. This is nothing but your recovered signal. This is the output of your sampling theorem. So this is the figure 3, and figure 1 is, this is for oversampling. and this is for your this is nothing but your right sampling. Right sampling is nothing but fs is equal to twice of your maximum frequency. So this one is sinusoidal waveform is the input I have given, and the next one, this is nothing but your sampled output, and after the recovery I'm getting the waveform 2 into fm. The next one is figure 1. This is nothing but your under sampling. If I do the under sampling, my original signal I cannot recover. If I do over sampling, then only I can recover my original sampling, original signal. So under sampling means some of the signal will get lost. So here you see in the negative part, some of the signal will be clipped off. This is because of your under sampling. So every time you have to make sure that if you want to sample any signal, it should be greater than are equal to twice than that of your maximum frequency. Thank you, students. So if you want to go for next program, use this one more screen, and then you type the program, and then next, if you want to run the program, use this run button to show the output. Now these are the output I have copied from the program what I have shown there. So after running that program, so this is the output for the under sampling and right sampling, and then over sampling. This is for over sampling. Now the result is the sampling theorem for critical frequency, under sampling and over sampling is simulated using MATLAB 2017, and the output is verified. Thank you, students.